just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends, and I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. Going places that I've never been, seeing things that I may never see again. I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. Like a band of gypsies, we go down the highway. We're the best of friends, insisting that the world keep turning our way. And our way is on the road again. I just can't wait to get on the road again. Love is making music with my friends, and I can't wait to get on the road again.
And soon I will come on, be there.
On the 5 o'clock. And we all stay on. So you're like, please go ahead.
Oh, she was coming in. I thought she was going out.
Okay. You just called my name.
Yeah, they sing
and out. And you know wherever I am, I'll come running.
I think the rest of your
party.
Thank
you.
You're welcome.
Winter, spring, summer, or fall, all you got to do is call.
Sweetie pie, how are you?
And I'll be there. Yeah. You got a friend.
The pastor has arrived. You get that pastor hat on too. My
if the sky above should turn dark and full of light.
All right.
And
okay, I got you.
No mention of the end
of the
world. I got you, LD.
Call my name, my love.
Oh, hi, Nina. How are you now?
And you don't know who he is because he don't have no picture of himself.
When history is summer, all you got to do is go. And I'll be there again. They'll hurt you and desert you. Will they take your soul if you let them? Oh, don't you let them. Oh, just call out my name. And you know wherever I am, I'll come running. Oh, babe, don't you know about when the spring summer falls? Hey, now all you got to do is call. Lord, I'll be there, yes, I will.
I'm not even trying to look at that
friend. You got a friend. Ain't it good to know?
Oh my God. Yeah, let me do it.
Ain't it good to know?
This is the promoting position, y'all. I'm the engineer, so I got y'all. So both are in the building here, and I have the beautiful, defined, the most absolutely talented Annette Harris in the room. I want you to call this number in. Before you call, I want to give a shout out to all my Mandela friends down there. Shabubu, Takfeliqua, and some blackened tilapia.
And wait, you are forgetting, Mr.
Don't put this on my wall.
I didn't mean.
Don't put this on my wall. Don't let
him. That's a whole different
vibe. Don't let him.
Don't put that on my wall.
No, not two clicks. Three clicks. Two clicks, dad.
Oh my God.
Two clicks, dad.
Right, all the loud. For the clicks that I hit with.
I can't believe you guys. And you really crying?
I'm sorry.
That's why I'm sorry. Like that. She looks a whole lot like me.
So see, y'all have been me to drink.
It's going
to
be
more.
Okay, Bo.
Oh.
Yeah. It'll be all right.
Okay. It's okay.
Yeah, she all on Facebook. I'm here with my African friends.
You've been listening to Angie Mamma's the Moon Decision Show.
All the way from Moon.
As we sign out, I want to give a shout out to the Ugandan friends. those are in the cave of Abdullah.
And the Zimbabwe football.
My King David friend in Turkey, formerly known as the Garden.
Adam and Eve's stepdaughters and all of them.
That was so mean.
You tell the truth because you know it. That's why you laugh.
That's why she laughed.
You ain't saying hello to an American on your show.
That's
yet.
All right, pat me one of them.
One of these million garlic breads.
No, I don't. I told you to put two
chips. Jerusalem Jimmy cakes.
Yeah, there you go.
Jerusalem Jimmy cakes.
Why are you taking a picture?
Are you
serious?
He was like mush.
So, just in case they poisoned you, people got evidence. I understand. I see your motive of
faith. All right, it's
Artistic, hold it.
What do you want me to do with it?
Hey, buddy.
Hey, Marlo.
Yes, sir.
Hey, Art.
Yeah?
I'm getting ready to go to the restroom. You want to go to the bathroom?
I'm not going to the bathroom. Taking a picture.
Smart. Buddy, you want to go to the restroom?
I know he's going to say something.
Marlo.
Come on in. Come on in.
Let's see what we do. We don't even
talk.
It's safety.
And we don't talk to each other. Oh, come on.
Oh, ladies do that.
Oh, ladies! Oh,
ladies
oh,
and oh. Members of community choir. Yes. You bless those that served and prepared it and made it possible.
Your face, I see.
Amen.
And you smile
at me. When we're together
so happy. Better question.
I'm about a Q&A. Oh, you were gonna go in. Oh,
it's always never
true. Always encouraging, loving.
You're Egyptian. I figured it out. You're Egyptian.
Yeah, of course, I have an Egyptian wife.
You're Egyptian, but you cover all the things.
I'm Creole.
So easy.
Why am I shouting?
Because
you haven't eaten. You ain't
even eaten yet. It's in their common area.
All depends on. I got a crack out there.
Merry Christmas, everyone. Merry on behalf of Megyn Kelly, Santa Claus is. Fox News didn't tell you that. Don't worry, boys.
Did you get a million?
Fox News, Jesus and Santa Claus are both Puerto Rican.
Oh! Did she do
the real Santa Claus on the no flight list?
Hello, for the record. Tell us about Dynasty. What happened?
Wait a minute. What happened?
Tell us about Duck Dynasty. Yeah, you guys, educate us.
No,
tell us about Duck Dynasty. Why do you disagree with the band?
I'm glad you asked me that. Several reasons why I disagree.
Now he won't talk.
Yeah, because I can't see myself. I'm having to talk and I can't see. When you look at me, you believe anything you want. Because I'm looking at me as all the... Duck Dynasty. One. Phil Robertson, it's been Phil Robertson all along. What do you expect from somebody raised in the hills? You know how they believe. You know how hillbillies believe. Number two, unlike preachers of L.A. who are proposed religious figures, these people pray at the end of every episode. I've not seen that from the preachers of L.A. or any of the other religious shows. I can respect their beliefs of faith. They openly mention church, God, prayer, the Bible, which I've only seen Dietrich Haddon talk about that little skinny girl and trying to chase her and get up with her. I've only seen Noel Jones running up behind that woman and Clarence McClendon looking prettier than his wife. That's all I've seen on Preachers of L.A., but I've seen some religious context in Duck Dynasty. Thirdly, hey, they were millionaires before A&E came along, and they're going to be millionaires after it's over. Believe me, when they come on the other side of this, Duck Dynasty is going to have 20 million more viewers. Me and my whole family are going to be one of them, because I'm pushing the Duck Dynasty campaign. If Flavor Flav can have a reality show, and he don't do nothing, a man with a business who's doing something, making money, and investing in his family, he need to be highlighted as well. Bring it on. Phil Robertson.
I'm Pavarotti.
So that means picture?
That means picture Vic.
Smile. Say hi, who are you?
Now he's saying hi.
You the one that brought up saying you was on vacation, whatever it is. You wanted to get the home.
Hello.
Say hi.
Wave.
Zachariah.
This is Zach's hand. This is Zach's hand. Oh, see, there's his other hand. See, this is Zach's hand. Zach was born with an adult hand and a little hand. Look at that. This is our gang sign.
But he's like, who is that?
I can't see.
Like, who is that? Indianapolis. There you go.
He's from,
we're here.
They live here.
Oh, y'all live here?
Yeah, scream out Evanston, Zach.
Oh, Evanston. Evanstonian. Look at him.
Don't try to get out, though.
Yeah, he wants to see.
Look, he want to see who that is.
Oh, let's do this.
See, that heathen got a little sister that's still praying for him because she don't understand. Mama, why don't he believe? Okay? So, like I said, you got to find different ways, different avenues. For a perfect example, different strokes for different folks. You can't use one stroke and think it's going to affect everybody.
Because it sure won't.
Okay? So you've got to use different methods and different ways to get your message across. You and I, we can go to the preacher and he tell us this, that, and the other. And we know how to take it straight on. We can take that bullet straight between the eyes. But that don't mean that she can.
Can I get in here?
That don't mean that she can. So. That don't mean that he can.
Your turn. Can I get in here since this is my argument?
Oh, okay.
No, I just need to get in. Cause you're
right. Put the disclaimer out there before you go there. I'm not necessarily against it because I haven't heard the song.
Right, I didn't say you was against
one,
it.
One, and then two, I don't want people to think that, you know, God is so up there that, you know, he's unattainable, as you alluded to earlier. However, I am gravely concerned with people conforming so much so that we are not able to tell who's who.
Okay.
In the music industry.
Come on. Oh, my knees hurt.
Put the other disclaimer that we're in the restaurant right now. That's why Aerosmith is playing in the background.
Okay, right. Here we go, though. You're talking to, and I'm not great by any stretch of the imagination.
Come on, Pastor, go ahead.
I got awards for songs I've written. I've written for some of the greatest artists in this country. Well, and sometimes I can't tell who's who when I go to a concert.
Absolutely.
I can't tell straight from gay. I can't tell man from woman. I can't tell real from unreal. Mm-hmm. So, I said it.
It's the truth. Come on.
Okay, so it's not conforming because my conviction is still there. If you listen, you will still say he's a Christian. But he's a Christian who's singing about life aspects that I've not heard a Christian talk about before. Somebody will listen to my song about middle-aged men and go, I never heard nobody say it like that before. Why? We got all these middle-aged men in the church. Stuff changing on you. We got to address this.
Hello.
Why we ain't talking
about
it?
Now you're stepping into my territory because you doing your music what I'm doing with psychology.
Come on.
Stuff is changing.
Somebody's got to address this.
We've been kind of closed-minded to stuff. And like you said, you got your son. He doesn't know whether or not he want to believe in God. You got so many things you're dealing with now. And it's not pushing God out the door. It's not pushing the Bible out the door. It's not pushing out how we did things before. But we may need to just look at some stuff. You know what I'm saying?
We need to change things up because the church is nowhere near the way it was 2,000 years ago. It was not the way it was 200 years ago. That society has changed. We need to change and adapt with that also. Why do we want to bring so much of the world into it?
But
because
we lose our power.
Hold on, Angie.
I
got the floor. I'm not finished.
No,
I'm not conforming. And I was about to go ahead and address that.
Okay.
Because, yeah, you bring the world in it because God is in the world. God is not just inside that little bitty building on the corner. Christians have dealt with divorce, they deal with molestation, deal with everything else that goes on in the world. So we need to address those inside the confines of the church as well. Yeah, go ahead, sing about that. Sing about the love between a man and a woman, that's a husband and wife, but sing about it in the sense of this is of God. This is what God intended for it to be. The love between a father and his child, or whatever the case may be.
But Panty Droppers is number one on Billboard.
That's not true, because Reverend Al Green did it.
Reverend Al Green
did it. He wasn't doing it for us.
Nope.
He was doing it in
saying about love and happiness.
He's doing it inside some of us.
Yeah, love, yeah, love, yeah, love and happiness. Love will make you do right. Love will make you do wrong. Love does not make you do wrong.
My turn.
Go ahead, run that
long. I think Christians are too spiritual.
I'm gone. I'm going to run through this
wall. Yes. Now, everything we do is too spiritual. And we are no natural good. Yeah, we are.
Listen to
the
point where
you're going
with it.
We are no. Everything. We no natural good. That's why they talk about a net show. Some people talk about a net show, and they say that we don't need counselors. We don't need psychiatrists and all these people.
I'll go to the Dynasty.
Yeah, it is. I'll go to Jesus, and he'll fix. He'll fix everything for me. Yes.
Really,
yes. But Jesus will fix a whole lot. Through this doctor,
yes.
Through this counselor, through this teacher, okay. Even through the carpenter, the ambulance guy called me and says, I go to church. He says, well, what I see in that pulpit, I want to be just like that. Them pastors I see up there. He said, I know God called me to do something. I said, really? Why you want to sit in the pulpit? He said, well, I can see how they affect the people. I said, what do you do for a living? He says, I'm an EMT worker. I said, you fool!
You affect the people.
I said, you realize how important your job is in ministry? Mm-hmm. I said, they see you before they see the doctor.
Yes, sir.
And the doctors need you. Because when I got stabbed in the face, stabbed in the back, stabbed in the chest, and I lost... both my lungs had collapsed.
He had to give the doctor the report.
The EMT worker looked at me, and he had two things that he could have done. Number one, he could have said, oh, my God, ooh, you about to die. And guess what? I'd have died, because if he said I'm about to die, I'm going to die. But he looked at me in my worst state, because I was getting ready to die. You know what he said? Oh, man, that's nothing. I got you. Come on, get in the van.
No preacher there? It wasn't an anniversary? Nobody had a gator. Don't blame.
Oh, just you and him.
He made sure that I didn't realize the severity of that man stabbing me. I lost so much blood that I was going to die if he didn't get there in 5 minutes. He said, oh, man, we put a bandaid on that. You good to go. When I got in the car, in the van, whatever that thing is, he put that gas mask on me. The ambulance.
Yeah, but I had
equipment. The van.
He put me in the hearse. When he put me in the hearse, he called the ball bearers over. and I heard them say, we taking him to Christ. And I said, wow, we can go to heaven in the ambulance, you know. But he was taking me to Christ Hospital, you know. And when they got me there, then the doctor says, we almost lost you.
Can I jump in here
at
this point? Okay, EMT, you're looking terrible. Oh, man, that ain't nothing. Uh-huh. These people going to hell.
Yeah.
It's enough of us telling them that.
Yeah.
I got to tell them, that ain't nothing. Come here.
Come here.
Then I got to sew them up.
Ooh, yeah. Hey, I think I felt
I can't. Oh, you going to hell. You ain't nothing.
Mm-hmm.
You bulldagger, you ain't nothing.
Right.
You drug dude, you ain't nothing. He know he ain't nothing. Mm-hmm. We've been told that. Right. He need my music to tell him you something. And I can, the Bible says we got to be wise.
Wise.
Yeah. I got to be wise enough not to lie to him.
Right.
Not,
right.
You all right. No, you ain't all right.
No.
But you all right enough to come here.
Absolutely.
And talk to me. And that's all I want. Now, when he get over here, then I'll let Ricky and them have.
Yeah.
Well, not Ricky.
No.
Not
Ricky.
Please don't let Ricky have one. No, not Ricky.
You don't need no more.
Y'all recording.
We don't know which Ricky you're talking about.
Well, whichever one.
He's not talking about Ricky.
Which Ricky?
Don't
know what Ricky.
Right, right. And think about it is, I don't even know which artist I give them to.
Oh, okay.
But I can let gospel have him because they can affirm him. But I just got to get him over here.
Yes.
I just got to get him here.
And don't put a whole bunch of clothes on him. See, because when he come to church, and our spiritual mind that says, her dress is too short.
Right.
He got this. Now, you come, what they say, come clean or stay away dirty. That's dumb. A doctor will lose his practice if he says, come healed or stay away sick. That's stupid. The church is the hospital, and you saying, come clean. Come well. Well, that's dumb.
We don't say that. Do we say that?
Yeah, y'all bad. Y'all perfect.
No.
And see, just so you get it, my mentality was, oh my God, Andre is terrible in my class. I always wanted Andre.
Yeah.
I could deal with straight A kids. I like the straight A kids. I want Andre. Because don't nobody else want him. And when Andre come out to be a success, it's going to be a great success.
See, I love that.
Because you don't expect Andre to do nothing.
Yeah.
That's what I want. I don't want the clean, prissy, that comes just, you know how to lift it. I don't want them. I want that nigga on the street that ain't never heard enough. That's what I want. I want the one that's in the car with the 22. I want that nigga.
Yeah.
That's the one I want.
Yeah.
I want him.
Yeah.
I mean, that's just like me at your job. At the board of
trying to convince me.
No, we on video. No, I'm trying to convince
you. Right. You just hit.
Right.
You just getting it.
You your purpose there, Cinderella. You got a
Cinderella?
Oh,
wow. That's a cupcake.
Because, I mean, it's just like at the job. When people get difficult calls, they're like, oh, no. Because everybody at the job, they don't know me as Abby. They know me as Tony. Okay, because Tony's my middle name.
Okay.
So when they get difficult calls and people on the other end cussing them out, they're like, get a call to Tony. Give it to Tony. And I'm like, well, what are y'all giving him? What's going on?
Break that over. Yeah,
I got a.
He has a vision.
Yeah, come on. Vision. Okay.
This is gonna be in the front. Napoleon, stop!
That's not good.
Look at all the men.
See, I was a short man.
Little boy.
What we do? We in the corner?
I know. I got my low in the snow. I got my low in the snow.
I'm playing the beat in the corner. I'm gonna hang it in the corner down. Aaron Lockner. right there. No, I kicked it up because I knew she was going to not like it, and I wouldn't want it to come out. And then I'll be on GCI. She'd be like, he didn't ask me.
Uh-oh.
Honey,
girl.
I'm so glad we got a chance to get here.
How old are you? You're over 40. How old are you?
I'm straight.